Last class we have learned about UCS and WCS and Cartesian, absolute Cartesian and relative Cartesian. Now we are going to learn about polar coordinate and absolute polar coordinate and relative polar coordinate. So for that, let me just show you about a unit course. So UN is the command for your unit in AutoCAD. Here you have this direction. So click on this direction, and here you see that this is the base angle that is set as east. Okay. And by default, counterclockwise direction is the positive direction. If you click on this clockwise, so then clockwise will be positive. It will calculate clockwise angle, clockwise direction as positive direction. So we are okay with our anti-clockwise direction, so we are not going to check this option. And what is the type for your angle unit? That is decimal degrees. That is okay for now. Okay, so we have other options like this. So when we require this unit, we will choose it. Right now it is okay. And about this length, unit type, that is decimal, so it is for your meter, millimeter, centimeter, for this kind of unit. And you have architecture and engineering and fractional and scientific. So this decimal and fractional is decimal and fractional is both for meter, millimeter and centimeter. But if you need units in fraction, not in point decimal, then you will choose fraction. And normal decimal is your digit. After point, you will get some digits. And architecture and engineering is for feet and inches. And architecture, in architecture, you get fractional inches. And engineering is normal decimal inches and decimal feet is there. And scientific is with the value of exponential value. Get. So let's choose decimal, and then you see that insertion scale. Okay, so insertion scale is for those kind of drawings when you will insert within this current drawing. So what you are going to insert, it will be inserted with this inches. Okay, so suppose you have a drawing that is set in millimeter, and here you are going to insert in inches, so it will be scaled so that it can be inserted in inches unit. Okay, so generally what we do is we match with our length type. Insertion scale we generally match with our length type, so that is going to be millimeters. Okay, because here we are going to draw everything, create everything in decimal, and if we do it, if we insert any other drawing in inches, so that will not fit within our drawing. And it will not match our drawing unit. So that's why insertion scale we will match with our length type. And about the precision, so how precise value you need. Okay, so if you need to round off, you can choose this first option. And up to 8 digit after point, this is the maximum precision you will get. So this is enough. And about the direction, we have already done. And lighting, So when we will place lights, when we will create 3D model, we will place lights, and this one for our lights. So we have two options, American and international. We will choose international and let's click on OK. So the X positive direction is your east. Here you can see, as per the WCS, it is set as this is the east. So your UCS is aligned with WCS right now. If you change this UCS, so here also it will be reflected that which direction is your east. So in the last class we have already seen. So let's go with this default condition. UCS is aligned with WCS, and let's go for this line. And let me start at this point. Here I have started. Now what I'll do, I will give length value and then the angle value. Okay, so for that, like first I will give length, then less than as a symbol, then I will put the angle like 90 and press enter. See, so from this point it has been connected here. You may ask, sir, this is not the 90 degree angle. Yes, this is not the right 90 degree angle, but I have taken the absolute polar. That means it will count from origin. That is absolute polar. So from this point, from this origin, this point is 90 degree, right? I have just defined this point from this origin with the absolute polar point, right? And this line just connected from this point to this point, right? Now let me show you again with relative polar. That I am going to do is add the rate, then the length value, then less than angle value, and enter. Now you can see that the same input, just only in the prefix I have added add the rate, and you are getting a straight line because it's calculating this coordinate value from the previous point. Or the last point. All right, so this how we can provide all this. And suppose you are doing this with dynamic input on. If you have this dynamic input on, so this is a very flexible. So for that, if you place your length value first, and in this dynamic input you can see that with your crosshair you are getting a small box. You are getting a small box, and within that your value is displayed. So here also you can place your angle. So to switch between another coordinate value, like angle, you just have to press tab. And there you put your value like 9. Okay. And the same thing happened. Okay. So if you press 30 and then you go for comma, so then it will take your y axis. And here you see that you got another small box after 30, and there you will put the y coordinate value. Okay, and again if you press comma, then it will take z coordinate value. Okay, so this is a simple thing. And Here you have this command line window, and here you can press all the commands there. And within this drawing area or viewport, if you right click, you will get some other options like pan, zoom, this action recorder. We'll come on this part later, action recorder. About quick select, quick calculator, and about the options. So here you can customize all other options, like for selection, all the options for selection, like pick box size, what will be the pick box size, what will be the grip size. Okay, so we will show you what is called pick box, what is called grip, and about grip color. So all the options related to that. Okay, and for preview, these are the options. So selection preview, command preview, all this active right now. And this ribbon option, this is so this contextual tab for the ribbon is displayed right now. And for this window selection method, what is what will be the default, or how you can do it, like click and click, okay, press and drag, both automatic detection. So we have two selection method. I'm going to show you that. And what will be the selection effect color? Okay, after selection, how it will look, what will be the color? So there you can change it. And selection mode, all these things are there. These are the options for your 3D modeling, for your drafting. This crosshair, within that crosshair, we have the box there. So you can change that aperture size. Okay, and all other settings are available here for plot and publish. Okay, these things are there for saving. So here you can save this pre-settings, all the things for your display. So here you can change your background color for your 2D model space. Background color is background black. For your crosshair, it is white, and other other interface element has its own color. So you can change, you can customize the color also. And here also this file tab control option is there, display. So if you uncheck this, it will not be displayed. And here you can change your crosshair size. So right now it is set as 25. If you change, it will be changed. Okay, now let's come to this line. So line, with this line option, you will be creating line segments, and it has its own command. With the command also, you can activate line. L is the command to activate, and you will be creating a line segment. So to create a line segment, you need minimum 2 points. Okay, so one will be your start point, one will be your end point. So let me show you that. And then you can click on here, and you can click on here. So you have defined two segments. 2 point, and that is created a line segment. And one line segment is an individual object, another line segment will be an individual object. So even if it is continuous, see, the line segments are continuous, but all the line segments will be individual. Okay, this is an individual, and when I'm selecting, you see, these are the grip points, these blue boxes are called grip points. Okay. With this grip points, I can change this object length also and change the position also. Like this, I can change it. Alright. Now we have this polyline option. So with this polyline, we can create a single element if it is continuous. So we can create a line, we can create arc with this polyline as well. Okay, and we can give a line width with this polyline. So if it is continuous, it will be a single element with this polyline. So let's go with this polyline and let me show you. This is the point I'm going to start, and then next, and then this will be the next line length. And now if you need arc, so you can go for arc. Here you see. Now again, you can bring your line back like this. Okay. And here also you can give line width. Okay. So that I'm going to show you later. Now you see that I had created one line segment there, another line segment there, another arc segment, another axis. So all those are continuous, created as a single element, right? Now let me show you that with the polyline option, how you can create an arrow. So let me show you. This is as a start point. Then let's create halfway. Let's create with the half. So what will be the starting half width and what will be the end half? So the starting half width, let me give like here I'm giving half width, okay. And ending half width, let me take as 2.5. And let me on this ortho mode so that I can get straight lines. So the shortcut is F8 for your ortho mode. So when you activate ortho mode, your cursor will or your crosshair will be restricted within 0 degree, 90 degree, 180 degree and 270. So let me do this, and here you see that we have created this one. So the half width, we have given this half width 2.5. Okay, and the total width is 5 now, and it has the same thickness at the start and at the end that we had defined. Now let me go with this width, and here I'm going to define the start width as 10 or 15, and what will be the ending width? That I'm going to define 0. So here you see that at the start of my line segment, the width 15, but when I'm going to end it, doesn't matter how much length it will be. Okay, so it's creating a pointing arrow. So now you see that you have created an arrow, and that is as a single element. This as a single element. You don't need to select like this as this. And so this as a single. So this is about your polyline. And now let me create this circle. Okay, so we have six different methods to create circle in AutoCAD. So you can see that the six different methods are divided into three categories. First is center base, second is point base, and third is tangent base. Okay, so the first category is center, and within that category we have two way, that is center radius and center diameter. And for second category we have also two options, 2 point or 3 point, and for the third category also tangent radius and tangent tan. So this last option, tangent tan, this cannot be completed, this cannot be executed with command. You have to do it with icon, okay? Or else you can come to this menu bar here, and there you can go for tools. Also within this also you can get it. So with this icon you have to execute this tangent tan. You cannot type any command. This cannot be activated, this cannot be executed with command. So let me just show you this first option, that is center radius. So you will be defining one point as a center and the value as a radius. So you can type now, let me go for center diameter. Now I need the same center. Okay, so what I am doing is, to highlight the center, I'm placing or I'm hovering my mouse on the perimeter of this circle, and it's highlighting its center point, right? So we have this object snap option on. Okay, so all the snap points for objects, for each an object, it will highlight if you have this object snap option on. Okay, so it will be very easy to place your objects, to create your objects at the right point. So F3 is the shortcut for your object snap option. So now let me snap on these points. See how easily it's snapping on this center point. If I don't on or activate this object snap, so I cannot say that I'm correctly placing at the exact center point. So there is a chance for error. So now I will not allow any error with this object snap, and let me place on the center, and then let's define your diameter. Okay, so diameter 26. Okay, so that is placed right now, and here you see that is 2 point. So with this 2 point you will be defining the diameter endpoint of your circle. So the 2 point, so this will be like, let me place on here, suppose this as the first diameter endpoint of your circle and the next endpoint of your circle. So you can place the next diameter endpoint with coordinate values as well. So let me just place it like at the rate, and what will be the diameter value that I'll be defining, like at the rate 25, that will be the diameter value for this circle, and less than 45. Okay, so this at this 45 direction, the next diameter endpoint will be placed. Okay, so at the rate 25, less than 45. Now you see that from this point, the next diameter endpoint is placed at 45 degrees, and the circle is created like this. Okay. So for this 2 point circle, you can easily create. If you don't know the center point, you have to calculate the center location. Don't waste your time calculating center location. You can create with this 2 point and 3 point there. If you know the 2 points and the 3 points there, you can easily place. So let's go with this 3 point now. So if you have any points, so let's go with this 3 point, and here let me select midpoint of these lines. So with this you can easily place your circle. Now we have a tangent radius option. So we need two tangent options that the new circle will be smoothly connecting those two objects with a specified radius. So like we have this two object we have, and it will at the default, at the initial stage, it may take the distance, approximate distance it may take at this box here you can see, or this this may be the last circle what you have created, this may be the last circle radius. Okay, so don't worry about that. You can define here, like let me define 5 as a radius. Okay, so here you can see this one is available. Suppose the distance is approximately here, let me check with the distance. Di is the command for distance from this point to this point. So that is 19.86. Now suppose if you have given the radius value more than this distance, so it may not be possible to place within this. It may be placed outside, where if you lengthen this line there it can be placed, like within this space it can be placed. Or if it is if the radius is too big, so that cannot be created. Like let me show you that tangent radius. Suppose I'm going to this as a first tangent object, then select this as a second tangent object, and then let me go with like 900 radius of circle. And here you can see that it is too big, it cannot be created within having tangent this object and this object. Now let's go for tan. So you just have to specify three tangent objects. This is your first tangent, this is your second tangent, and this is your third tangent. Okay, so it's simply created this. Okay, I think this 900 has been created over there. Let me just the properties, control 1, and for the radius, yes, this is the 900 radius circle. So control 1 is for your properties palette. So as I mentioned that it may be possible that it is created outside. So if you lengthen this line, it will be tangent, and if you lengthen this object, it will be tangent with this circle. And we have also some arc over there. So arc is nothing like incomplete curve, you can say. So it will be never closed within 360 degree. So we have 11 different ways to create arc. So this is very, very easy to create arc, like a 3 point. As per the name, you can see that you have to specify 3 points, okay, and start, center, end, okay. Just the first point you will be defining, that will be taken as the start, and the next point will be taken as the center, and then you will be defining a next point as the end. So between the starts and end, it will define the angle and the length of your arc. So like the similar, you will be mentioning all the options. So here, let me just show you few options which are similar, like center. You see start, center, end. So this is similar here, like this center, start, end. This is similar here. So let me just go with this start. Just here, center comes first, here start comes first. So this is your start point, and let me define this point as the center. So here you can see, and where you want to end, that will be the angle. Okay, like this. Now let me just go with this start, center, length. This start center angle, same like specifying start point, center point, and you just specify the angle value rather than specifying an end point. So let's go with this start center length, start point, then the center point, and we will be defining the length. Okay, the length you will be defining. So let me define the length. And here you can see one thing, that it going towards the anti-clockwise direction, that is the positive direction. Okay, so the default curve with the positive values will be created towards anti-clockwise direction. So let me define the length, like and here let me show you the distance from this point to this point is 200. There you can see, right? Here also you can create your arc, and this start end direction. So you define start point, you define end point, then about the angle. So it will take an angle direction from the tangent. Okay, from its tangent it will create like this. Okay, so if you define 90 degree, it will be the tangent direction of this arc. Okay, and if you define 45, it will be the tangent direction of arc. So if you draw a 45 line, a line in 45 degree or 30 degree angle, and if you make it tangent, so the arc will be created like this. So there you can define the angle 90 degree. And the other options are similar. So you can simply create, and about the 3 point, you just define first point, second point, and third. Like this. So it's very simple to create an arc. Now let's go for creating rectangle and polygons. Yeah. And after showing you all this, I will share you one task, one diagram I will share with you. You have to complete that. So let me just show you about rectangle, how you can create rectangle. So to create a rectangle, you need 2 points. Okay, you need two number of points to create your rectangle there. So what you can do is you can specify your point with coordinate values, or you can specify with mouse pointer. So let me specify first point with 0, 0, enter. And with this dynamic input, if I go with the next value, it will be taken as a relative. Okay. So if I don't want to calculate with relative, I will either deactivate the dynamic input mode and I will press the normal value. But if I want to put my absolute Cartesian value, yes, absolute Cartesian value with activating this dynamic input, so how you can do that? So for that, what you have to do is in the prefix you have to place hash and then type your value. Like let me go with 1000 or 10,000 comma 15,000, and now here you can see that it has taken the absolute value, absolute Cartesian. Okay, now again, if I don't place hash in the prefix, relative Cartesian, here you can see it has taken @ in the prefix. Okay, so you have defined the first corner point and the opposite corner point of your rectangle, and with this 2 point you have created your rectangle. Now you can define your length and width rather than defining your corner points. So after defining your first corner point, after placing your first corner, then you can go with this area dimension. So let me go with this dimension. So like 5000, that will be the length. So length is your x direction and width will be your y direction. So there, let me go with 1000. Now the length 5000 can be placed in x positive and y positive also. So just you have to define the location where it will be. Like from this first corner point, it will be towards negative x direction or positive y direction, and this is the same for y, positive y direction or negative y direction. So where it will be from the first corner point, you just have to place and click. Now it is fixed with its position. Now again going with the first corner point, and after that you can mention the area. What will be the area? So there you can mention it. So let me go with equation. If I can mention there, 5000 into 7000. Okay, so it's not taking any equation there. Not taking, you have to put any value there. So you can place any area value, like let me put this. And now So it's asking about mentioning what will be the length. So that is the length. And here we have placed. Now about this one, let's go with this rotation. If you need to place with any angle, like 45 degree angle, and after that you can give dimensions like as a rectangle here. Same length and width, like this, you can place. Now, before specifying your first corner point, you can customize your rectangle. Like you want your corner to be smooth or to be chamfered, or you need width or to be placed at any height. With this elevation, you need thickness, so that you can place before specifying your first corner point. So you can customize your rectangle. So let me just show you with this chamfer. So you have to specify two chamfer distance, first chamfer distance and second chamfer distance. So the second chamfer distance and the first chamfer distance, let's specify. So let's go with this as the first and 100 as second chamfer distance, enter. And now let's specify first, and for this rotation I'll give 100. And here you see you have a rectangle like this, which have the first chamfer distance, second chamfer distance. Okay. So in this direction, this, from this first corner point towards this x positive direction, it has taken the second chamfer distance, and towards the y positive direction, it has taken the first chamfer distance now, and it will alternate to right, circulate, alternate values, like towards x positive direction, first value has been taken. The second chamfer distance, and here it has taken the first chamfer distance, then second chamfer distance, then first chamfer distance, second chamfer distance, then first chamfer distance, second chamfer distance, like this. Now let's go with this fillet option. Now let me define 500, and here you can see. Okay, and all the things you can define, area, length, width, you can define after that. Now about this elevation, so it will be placed at a height. Okay, now here you can see from the front, you can see that all the rectangles are placed at XY, the Z value is 0. And if you go for any like 500, and let me come to this top, and here if I go for the rectangle there, and now if you check from the front, you will see that you have placed at 500 height. Okay, so let me keep the elevation height a little bit bigger, like that. Let me come to this top. There, let me, and now come to the front, and there you can see you have placed it at height. That is the elevation, right? And you can control, you can go to control one, and there, yes, so there you can see that this, it has the elevation 5000. You can change it after that also. Now again, let me show you this width option. So like the polyline, it will have some width over there. And here you can see it has some width. Okay, it has some line. Okay. And now again, let me go with this. Let me just show you. So it has some width, but here you can see it has a line from the front. Now let me go with this thickness now. Okay. So here let me go with 5000 as the thickness, and let me create groups this size. Okay. Now if you check, you see it has some thickness towards Z direction. So that is your thickness. That is your thickness, and you have created one width over there. Okay, so that is not a 3D element, that is a 2D element. You can convert it also in 3D element. So we can also do that. So only if you have provided the thickness, then only you can convert it to solid or 3D mode. So for that also we have one command, convert to solid. This is the command, convert to solid, and you select this object and then press enter. And now if you hover your mouse across here, it will show you that this is right now 3D solid. Now change the visual style to realistic. And there you can see that this is 3D solid, the wall-like object you have created. Okay. So that can be achieved by rectangle. We have other options like creating a polygon. So you can define your number of sides. So the minimum number of sides is 3. And the maximum number of sides is 1024 in AutoCAD. So let's go with this minimum number of sides, that is 3. And let me go with this geometric center. So this is your geometric center. So with this object snap, you can highlight this geometric center. And then what kind of polygon it will be? It will be inscribed or circumscribed, that you have to mention. Let's go with this inscribed, and then you have to define the radius. Okay, you have to mention the radius like this. Let me mention this as a radius. And if I go with the center radius, and this is the center, and this is the radius. So you see that within this radius, this is the inscribed, right? And if I go for a polygon and the number of side is 3, so if I need that same value, so without typing the value, I will just press enter and go for center. Choose this center, and now let's go with the circumscribed, and this has the same radius. And now you see that this is the circumscribed. Okay, so the difference between inscribed and circumscribed will be like it may have the same radius value, the same center, the same everything, same sides, but the side length of a polygon that you have created by inscribed and circumscribed, the circumscribed one will be greater than inscribed. Okay, so this is to this. I hope it is clear now for you. Let me go to this. share with you one diagram. So let me just show you here. Let me go with this attach option there. Let me go with this. Let's see. Downloads. Let me open this. We will specify. So that's okay now. Let me specify this point. So with this line curve, you can create. You have to create this diagram, okay? And if you face any problem, I will show you. I will help. So this is all for today. I hope it is clear. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me.